Hello, everybody. It's really late in the evening here in Ireland now, but I felt like I really need to put this video out as soon as possible. There's no panic or anything like that. Just an important, really important, really important concept, you know. First, as usual, the disclaimer. You can pause the video and check. This is not a signal. This is not an investment. I'm not a financial advisor. This is just educational video. And basically, all the money that you have, it's all the trades that you do, that they're done in your risk. I'm only sharing my ideas. You can have a read and pause this. Okay, so that's that. So I was just talking with a trader now, who is, I could honestly say, more experienced than I am, and he just sent me this really interesting picture. Basically, that's his picture here. But I'll go to the bigger one, and I've read about these things, and I've heard about these things, but probably I just never really consider it throughout. But you can also type in Google to find this photo, this picture, because it's hard to get a good quality. So Wall Street cheat sheet, write this into Google and you'll find it. So basically, what this is a explanation how the bubble works, right? So first you have this belief and then hope, when the price is down there and people start believing and optimism, oh, this is a good rally, you know, you can make money, and then belief, time to get fully invested, thrill, now everybody knows about cryptocurrency, and then euphoria, I'm a genius, everybody thinks they know what they're doing, right? And then if you have a sell-off, and then complacency, we just need to cool off. The next week rarely you kind of think, okay, you know, it's just a retracement, you know, we're gonna come back, but what happens there is like you start to go down, and then anxiety, you know, why am I getting margin call, it's taking longer than expected, and then denial, investments are with great companies, they will come back. Of course I'm referring to cryptocurrency. And then panic, shit, everyone is selling, I need to get out. And then a capitulation, I'm getting 100% of the markets, I can't afford to lose more, and then anger and depression and all. And disbelief. Okay, so yeah, I really recommend, you know, just taking a really good look into this picture, and you know, if you can relate this to the, I'm not saying that Bitcoin is gonna crash. I'm just saying that we have to be aware of the possibility. Right now, everybody's so enthusiastic about it, right? Oh, it's gonna go up into the moon. Well, it can't, you know, it can't. I mean, I still believe it's bigger chance that it has better chance that it will, like Bitcoin, it will go higher. But as a smart investor, you need to be real and be aware that could also go the other way, and this is one of the possible opportunities where it can go, right? So this is, if you compare this bubble theory to the Bitcoin chart, this is Bitcoin chart, by the way, just updated a few minutes ago, you can actually see it's almost same, right? It's incredibly, incredibly, you know, the similarities are just amazing, and I don't think this picture was you know, made for Bitcoin. This is just for general trading and stocks and all that. Okay, so it is one of the possible scenarios, so please, when you are investing, please consider, you know, it's good to be optimistic and all, but be real as well, because if we look into Bitcoin chart, you know, this is kind of like the situation we were showing, right, in that photo. But so the most important line to look for, and I've said this in previous videos, but I can't stress this enough, okay? This is so important. This is so important for everybody in cryptocurrency, and not just for those who have Bitcoins, but for all altcoins, and you know, basically for all cryptocurrency world, okay? This is the most important, by far the most important thing you need to look at, is this triangle, right? So it's kind of like consolidating, and we said it could go up, it could go down, but if it starts going down and it doesn't find the support, it really looks similar to that photo that we saw, and the picture actually. And how does this relate to altcoins? Well, basically, when Bitcoin is going down, all the altcoins are going down with him, not with it, right? So you can actually put a comparison here. You can compare, for instance, with Ethereum. Okay, because it's, you know, the biggest altcoin. By the way, about altcoins are altcoins that are not Bitcoin. So if we compare those two, you can observe that when Bitcoin has a big sell-off, also, you know, the altcoins, including Ether and all of them, suffer even more, right? They go down even lower. You know, the Bitcoin has a big impact. So sorry, I'm just gonna, it's really late, but I had to put this out. So we had a situation there. Okay, for instance, here in September, Bitcoin goes down, it brings Ethereum with it and all the other altcoins. I mean, just Ethereum is the best representative. And then when Bitcoin is going sideways, like it's going now, altcoins are rising. Okay, so this is Bitcoin in June, and you see it's going sideways. Okay, but then Ethereum had a correction as well. But this is basically how the market works when Bitcoin is going up. Everything else is kind of like standing. I was looking here, for instance, Ethereum is kind of flat. And this is coming from a guy with more experience that I'm just kind of like, he gave me this warning, and then I went back and I did my research, and I highly recommend for you as well. Like, you're trading with your own money, so do your own research. You can see here, so when Ethereum was standing still, when Bitcoin was going up, right? And then Ethereum was standing still, Bitcoin was going up, because all the money in the crypto world goes into him. And now, okay, Bitcoin sells down, and then eventually, everybody, okay, where do I put my money? You have the money on your exchange, so of course you're in crypto, you want to do something with it, so you just say, okay, I'm gonna put it in Ethereum. So you start putting in Ethereum. It kind of makes sense, doesn't it? So I'm just sending out this warning to be aware. And also, like, to be honest, the signals that I'm getting lately from Bitcoin, I'm not really optimistic. Of course, nothing is clear yet because we have this line and we have to observe it. But just for instance, today, what was going on? You know, we had this strong rally up, and now we're selling down. You know, usually after this strong rally is up, you would expect. Okay, this is a, it's still in a, if you look at this, it's an Elliott wave, it's in a correction wave. We had one, two, three. Actually, it's not, this is a fourth wave, so it shouldn't have been that low, you know. And again, a few days ago, we had a strong rally up, and you know, we started to get optimistic, and again, it's held down. But I'm not saying this is like yet a final signal, but it's not, it's just making me more and more cautious. I'll give you that. And here again, like, we had a strong rally up, and it's down. Because what you want to see after these strong rallies, like this candle here, strong pushes up, you would, in a strong market, you would expect them to kind of lead somewhere, but then you just sell off, and you have strong and sell off, and you have this strong push up, and it sells off again. So be really careful, right? If Bitcoin does go down here and sells off, you know, all the altcoins, and I don't care what you have, is it HIVE? You know, kind of. A lot of my friends on Facebook are strong believers in HIVE, and I'm the same. Everything that I've read about, everything that I've, you know, I don't own it yet. I was looking for the right price, because I was kind of late to the party. But you know, if it's HIVE, it's Ethereum, it's Zcash, it's Ripple, it's all of them, right? So be careful. And for those who are not invested yet, you know, just, you know, just wait to see what this happens. If you're cautious, I mean, there are small trades than I was doing today. I had that video with Bitcoin. I bought here, and but this is like a day trade. This is totally different to buying and holding. This is just you go in, you go out, you have your stop loss, and you know, it doesn't affect you if the price goes down because you're already out of the market. So. Okay, just wanted to share this for late night if somebody is watching this straight after. Good night. All the best.